Our respected teachers and viewers, assalamu alaikum and a very good evening. Myself Muhammad Aftab Ahmed, representing the group 5 from roll number 61 to 75 of first phase. From the past few months, we are living in a society which has been affected by a kind of virus affecting physically and mentally to the human beings. Today, the phonetic corona itself is a hefty word that awakes and causes a kind of fear among the people. So today let us have a brief look and get aware about the coronavirus. What are coronaviruses? Coronaviruses are a large family of viruses that cause illness ranging from the common cold to the more severe disease such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome. What is COVID-19? COVID-19 is the illness caused by the novel coronavirus, Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2 or SARS-CoV-2. History of coronavirus. Coronaviruses were first discovered in the 1930s in the domesticated chickens. Arthur Slack and McHorn described in 1931 a new respiratory infection of chickens in the North Dakota, characterized by gasping and listlessness. Fred Beaudet and Charles Hudson, 6 years later, successfully isolated and cultivated the infectious bronchitis virus. In the 1940s, the two more animal coronaviruses, mouse hepatitis viruses, MHV, and transmissible gastroenteritis virus, TGEV, were isolated. Human coronaviruses were discovered in the 1960s. E.C. Kendall, McLon Beyon, and David Tyrrell at the British Medical Research Council isolated novel common cold virus, B814, from a boy. In 1960, Dorothy Hamre and John Prokhor at the University of Chicago isolated a novel cold virus 229E from medical students. The novel virus 229E, like the virus strain B814, when inoculated into the volunteers, caused a cold and was inactivated by ether. Almeida, through electron microscopy, showed that B814 and 229E were morphologically related to their distinctive club-like spikes. Other human coronaviruses like SARS-CoV in 2003, HCoV-NL63 in 2004, HCoV-HKU1 in 2005, MERS-CoV in 2012, and SARS-CoV-2 in 2019 are identified. Structure of coronavirus. Coronaviruses are large, roughly spherical particles with bulbous surface projections. The average diameter of the virus particles is around 125 nanometer. The diameter of the envelope is 85 nanometer and the spikes are 20 nanometer long. The viral envelope consists of lipid bilayer in which the membrane, envelope and spike structural proteins are anchored. How it is spread? Most people are being infected from other people. It probably spreads the same way as cold and flu, through the droplets which are created when we talk, cough and sneeze. People can get infected when these droplets enter the nose, eyes or mouth. Touching contaminated objects puts the droplets on your hands, and the hands touch your faces, and droplets can enter your nose, eyes and mouth. Symptoms. Most common symptoms includes fever, dry cough, tiredness. Less common symptoms includes the itches and pain, sore throat, diarrhea, conjunctivitis, headache, loss of smell and taste, rash on skin, discoloration of finger and toes. Severe or serious symptoms includes difficulty in breathing or shortness of breathing, chest pain or pressure, loss of speech and movement. Pathophysiology. The pathophysiology involves the respiratory system. The alveoli has type 1 and type 2 pneumocytes, where type 1 helps in gas exchange and type 2 produces the surfactant, which decreases the surface tension within the alveoli and prevent the alveoli to collapse. The virus mainly affects the type 2 pneumocytes. The virus has different types of spike proteins in it and single stranded RNA. Among this, the S spike proteins are very important because it can attach with the receptor present on the type 2 pneumocytes. The receptors are called ACE2, angiotensin converting enzyme type 2. These receptors help in virus to get to the cell As soon the virus gets into the cell, it releases the single stranded RNA. This RNA hijacks the cell ribosomes and starts making the different protein molecules. These are nothing but the different structural proteins of viruses itself. It also uses another enzyme, RDRP. This enzyme helps in synthesizing more RNA molecules. The different polyproteins are cleaved by protease enzyme and converted to different structural components of virus, like capsids, spikes, and different enzymes. The combination of the virus with RNA makes a complete virus. This is how the virus replicates in our body. Prevention and controlling measures. Maintaining good personal hygiene. Wash your hand frequently with soap. Use alcohol-based sanitizers. Cover your cough and sneeze. Do not share your drinks and personal items. Avoiding exposure. Keeping 1 to 2 meters away from others even if they appear well, to avoid direct contact with them. Avoid touching your face, eyes, nose and mouth. Avoid shaking hands, kissing and hugging. Avoid activities which expose you to a large group of people. Clean and disinfect the frequently touched surface each day. Keep away from people who are sick. Diagnosis. In India, tests available for COVID-19 are RT-PCR test and immunoassay. Coming to the treatment, till now there is no treatment for the disease, only the symptoms are being relieved and are being given the immunity boosters. There is a chart of interpretation of COVID-19 PCR and immunoassay test showing the interpretation and clinical significance. A sample of laboratory report of COVID-19 showing the negative is shown. Coming to the scenario at the world. The first outbreak was identified in Wuhan, China in December 2019. World Health Organization, WHO, on 30 January declared this outbreak as public health emergency of international concern. WHO on 11th of March declared outbreak as pandemic. Till now, total worldwide, confirmed the cases are 17.9 million with the death of 680,000 people. On the top of the page, the graph shows how each day shows new cases reported since the previous day. A pie chart shows that different countries getting affected with three hotspots: US, Brazil and India. Scenario at India. The first case of coronavirus was reported on 30 January in 2020 in Karnataka. As of, total confirmed cases are 1.75 million and deaths up to 37,364. The major hotspots in India are Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Delhi and Karnataka. Scenario at Karnataka. Till 31st July in Karnataka, the confirmed cases were 1,24,115 with a recovery of 49,788 and deaths of 2,314. Vaccine trials around the world. Scientists and several companies around the world and are working on potential treatments and vaccines for COVID-19. A very first vaccine which is under the phase 2 of trial is AstraZeneca by United Kingdom. Likewise, the other vaccines like AD5nCoV under phase 2 by China, Corona VAC under phase 1 by China, and so on. Vaccine trials in India. In India, many of the pharmaceutical companies and researchers are working for the vaccine for coronavirus. Here are some of the list of vaccine which has been preparing by the Indian companies. The Covaxin, India's first indigenous COVID-19 vaccine developed by the Bharat Biotech, has successfully entered the human trial. Likewise, the other vaccine which are being preparing in India are ZYCoV-D, Serum Biological E, etc. Role of Corona Warriors. The Corona Warriors are the doctors, nurses and the ASHA workers. They are the frontline warriors who are treating the patients fearlessly by wearing a personal protective equipment, PPE. Apart from them, the policemen, the traffic police, municipal workers, administration has played a very important role in maintaining the harmony among the people during this lockdown. Coming to the message, today we see the people are careless about their health. thinking that nothing happens to them. But if you visit a hospital where a patient is in ICU and his family members waiting outside and praying for his recovery without a sip of water, which eventually may affect their health. So our message is that if something happens to you, more than you, your family will be in the trouble. So avoid going to the crowded areas, stay home, stay safe. Lastly, we would like to thank that the Dean and Head of the Department of Physiology, Dr. Saleem sir, and Department of Physiology for guiding us and making this teamwork successful. Thank you.